Let me start with a good morning, because it is an actual very good morning here in Harrisburg. You know, I was staff for 11 years, and I'm in my 10th year as a legislator. That means I have more than two decades of hanging around this building and seeing a lot of really dumb things. One of the dumbest things I've seen in Harrisburg my entire career is our natural tendency for one group to kind of hang out in their corner, talk only amongst themselves, have themselves so absolutely convinced that everybody's out to get them. And literally on the other side of the room is another corner of people that are so convinced that everybody is out to get them because they're only talking to themselves. And the goals of breaking down those silos, getting people to play a game of legislative Red Rover where people could go from one side of the room to the other and have actual conversations with each other is so unbelievably important. And that's why the Blue-Green Caucus and this alliance is so absolutely urgent as we're looking to break down those partisan and frankly those walls that are based entirely on preconceived notions. And in fact, it was the Blue-Green Caucus that gave us the opportunity, dare I say the environment, pun intended, to be able to do real legislative work. It is more than just simply bringing people together. It's giving us a chance and creating an atmosphere where we can make real policy changes that will impact the lives of Pennsylvanians from Erie to Philadelphia, and I must say, places like Allentown too. And that's what we saw when we were able to pass in a bipartisan fashion House Bill 1842, which is our community solar legislation. Katie knows we've been working on this bill for more than a decade here in Harrisburg. And we've had so many challenges along the way, but we were able to realize that with new federal investment coming down, we can leverage those dollars to not only make sure that we're investing in clean, environmentally friendly energy production in Pennsylvania, but we're able to do so in a manner that doesn't just mean it's for people that have multiple acres of land at home, people that have the opportunity to own their own generation, whether they live in a small row home or an apartment or in a kind of a gated community or a mobile home park that won't allow them to install solar panels. And so not only is it the right thing to do for those consumers, allowing everybody to have access to solar, not only is it the right thing to do for our environment, making sure that we have cleaner air, cleaner water. But 75 of the largest contractors that do community solar installation are signed as member with the IBEW and related trades. That means the work that we are doing, this legislation that was only able to pass in the bipartisan manner because of the great work of Representative Krueger and Representative Fiedler and others like them, is not only, again, making our communities cleaner and creating more electricity here in Pennsylvania, but it's putting Pennsylvanians to work and family-sustaining, good-paying union jobs, again, across the entire Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. And it is because of the great work of the Blue-Green Caucus and so many legislators who don't want to be part of that really stupid thing that we've done for years by saying, we're in our corner, you're in corner, and never the two should meet. And this is just one example of a number of bills that is being led by the House Democrats, and we're reaching out to our friends in the Senate to ask them to get out of your corner and meet us somewhere in the middle so that all of Pennsylvania can benefit.